Welcome back to our channel, everyone. Wishing everyone a day filled with the grace of Christ. We hope you enjoy this video and subscribe to this YouTube channel to stay updated with the latest information. Join us on this journey and listen to this video until the very end. In the midst of the world's chaos and uncertainty, the faithful are being called to heed the divine messages revealed through the life and visions of Santa Faustina Kowalska and the Virgin Mary. These messages, steeped in spiritual significance, provide a beacon of hope and guidance for humanity as it faces an unprecedented era of challenges, including natural disasters, social unrest, and spiritual crises. The narrative woven by these revelations is one of profound spiritual preparation, urging believers to strengthen their faith, trust in God's mercy, and remain vigilant in the face of impending trials. Santa Faustina Kowalska, often referred to as the Apostle of Divine Mercy, was a Polish nun whose life was marked by deep spiritual experiences and an unwavering commitment to spreading the message of God's infinite mercy. Her mystical encounters with Jesus Christ, during which she received profound revelations, have become a cornerstone of modern Catholic devotion. Faustina's life was characterized by suffering, both physical and spiritual. She endured severe illnesses, including tuberculosis, which ultimately claimed her life at the young age of 33. However, it was through these sufferings that she developed an intimate connection with Jesus, who entrusted her with the mission of spreading the message of divine mercy to the world. One of the most significant revelations she received was the image of divine mercy, which depicts Jesus with rays of red and white light emanating from his heart, symbolizing the blood and water that flowed from his side at the crucifixion. This image, along with the chaplet of divine mercy, has become a powerful symbol of God's love and forgiveness. Jesus also instructed Faustina to promote the Feast of Divine Mercy, which is celebrated on the first Sunday after Easter, as a day of grace for all who seek his mercy. Faustina's diary, which chronicles her spiritual journey and the messages she received, is now considered a spiritual treasure, offering profound insights into the nature of God's mercy and the importance of trusting in his divine love. Her writings emphasize that no sin is too great to be forgiven if one turns to God with a contrite heart. This message of hope and forgiveness is particularly relevant in today's world, where many are burdened by guilt, despair, and a sense of unworthiness. As the world continues to grapple with various crises, the Virgin Mary's messages take on an even greater sense of urgency. Through her apparitions, particularly those at Medjugorje, Mary has conveyed warnings about the state of the world, urging humanity to return to God and prepare for the trials that lie ahead. These warnings include predictions of a mysterious plague, global conflicts, and natural disasters that will impact several countries, including Austria, Turkey, Guatemala, Mexico, Costa Rica, Argentina, and the United States. Mary's messages stress the need for spiritual readiness and repentance. She calls upon the faithful to intensify their prayers, particularly through the Rosary, and to live in a state of grace. The Virgin Mary has emphasized that these times of tribulation are not meant to inspire fear but to awaken souls to the reality of God's justice and mercy. She assures the faithful that those who remain close to God and follow her guidance will receive divine protection during these challenging times. A significant portion of Mary's messages revolves around the importance of the Eucharist, sacramentals, and the invocation of Saint Michael the Archangel. These spiritual tools are presented as essential means of safeguarding oneself from the forces of evil and the calamities prophesied to come. The Eucharist, as the true presence of Jesus Christ, is described as the bread of life that sustains the soul and fortifies it against spiritual attacks. Mary urges the faithful to receive the Eucharist frequently and with a pure heart, as it is a powerful source of grace and protection. Sacramentals, such as blessed medals, scapulars, and holy water, are also emphasized as important means of spiritual defense. These objects, when used with faith, serve as tangible reminders of God's presence and a means of invoking His protection. The Rosary, in particular, is highlighted as a powerful weapon against evil, capable of bringing peace to troubled hearts and homes. The Virgin Mary also instructs the faithful to invoke Saint Michael the Archangel, the protector against the forces of darkness. St. Michael's role as a defender of the Church and the faithful is critical in the spiritual battle that is intensifying in the world today. Consecrating homes and families to Saint Michael is recommended as a way to ensure divine protection against the increasing influence of evil. In addition to spiritual preparedness, Mary's messages call for a renewed commitment to charity, humility, and service to others. In times of crisis, these virtues become even more essential, as they reflect the love of God and the Gospel's teachings. Acts of charity are presented not only as a way to help those in need but also as a means of spiritual growth. Mary emphasizes that by serving others, especially the poor and suffering, the faithful can draw closer to God and experience His grace in a profound way. This call to charity extends beyond material assistance. It includes offering prayers, providing comfort, and showing compassion to those who are struggling. Humility is also a key theme in Mary's messages. She urges the faithful to abandon pride and self-reliance, recognizing that true strength comes from God. By cultivating humility, believers can better align themselves with God's will and become more receptive to His guidance. Throughout these revelations, there is a strong emphasis on the need for spiritual vigilance and repentance. The Virgin Mary's messages are a call to action, urging the faithful to remain steadfast in their devotion to God and to be prepared for the trials that are coming. This spiritual vigilance includes regular prayer, participation in the sacraments, and a commitment to living a life that reflects the teachings of the Gospel. Mary's messages are not only warnings but also reminders of God's infinite mercy. She reassures the faithful that even in the darkest times, God's love is ever present, and His mercy is always available to those who seek it. This assurance of divine mercy is a source of hope, encouraging believers to persevere in their faith and trust in God's plan. As the world faces an uncertain future, the messages of Santa Faustina and the Virgin Mary offer a path of hope and spiritual renewal. They call on the faithful to deepen their relationship with God, to trust in His mercy, and to prepare for the challenges that lie ahead with courage and faith. In embracing this divine call, believers are encouraged to act with love and compassion toward others, to remain steadfast in prayer, and to use the spiritual tools provided by the Church to protect themselves and their families. By following the guidance of these heavenly messages, the faithful can navigate the coming tribulations with confidence, knowing that God's mercy and protection are with them. In these times of trial, the Virgin Mary's protective presence serves as a reminder that no matter how great the challenges, God's love and mercy are always greater. The faithful are invited to respond to this call with open hearts, trusting in God's plan and striving to live lives that reflect His love and mercy to the world. Thank you for being part of this journey. Your presence and engagement make this exploration meaningful and impactful. Until next time, may you find inspiration and hope in the shared stories of our human experience.